Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa salatu wa salam ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka anta al-'alim hakim, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-'aliyyil 'azim. So inshallah, we just wanted to quickly go over some of the rulings in regards to the Salat al-Eid, given the context that we're going to be in, where many, if not all of us, are not going to be able to go to the masajid for the Eid Salat. And this is going to be going according to the Shafi'i school of law. So in the Shafi'i school of law, the actual ruling for the Eid Salat itself is considered to be a sunnah. It's a very emphasized sunnah, a sunnah mu'akkadah. However, it is a sunnah. And so because it's deemed to be a sunnah salat, there is no obligation for it to be prayed in the masjid. So that it is permissible for one to pray the Eid Salat at their home. Now, if one is able to pray with a group, meaning that, you know, if one is praying with one's family, then they can take in consideration all of the sunnahs associated with the Eid Salat in terms of the actual performance itself. So that is taking into consideration the prayer itself and also the khutbah that is delivered afterwards. Because for the Eid Salat, the order is switched, because the Eid Salat is similar to Jummah, in that there's a khutbah as well as the prayer. However, for the Eid Salat, the prayer comes first and then the khutbah comes second. Now, in terms of the actual prayer itself, the prayer itself consists of 7 and 5 additional takbirs, the saying of Allahu Akbar. So in the Shafi'i school, the way that one would begin it is that they would have initially the intention for the Eid Salat, and the timing for the Eid Salat needs to be sometime after the sun has risen, so in the permissible time of praying after Salat al-Fajr and before the coming of noon, more or less before the coming of Salat al-Dhuhr. And so the timing is going to be somewhere, you know, in between this time, and the Imam, whoever is going to be leading the Salat, whether it's an individual at home or if you're going to have someone else lead you who's going to be in your home, then initially you will start out with the opening takbir, the opening Allahu Akbar, and then after that, there will be 7 additional takbirats. So you will say Allahu Akbar 7 additional times. And and it's sunnah that in between the takbirats that you actually glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By saying Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. And so between the 7 takbirat, that you say this, and then after that you begin with the Fatiha and then the surah after that. And then when you stand up to do the second rakah, you will say the Allahu Akbar for the standing to start the second rakah, and then you would do 5 additional takbirat. So there'll be 5 additional takbirats after that. So there'll be a total of 12 additional takbirats that are in addition to it. And then after the salat itself, then you would have the khutbah that be given. And so the khutbah is going to be similar to that of Jummah. But again, this is in the case that there is more than one person that is there. If there's not more than one person, then you would just pray the Eid Salat itself, and that would be sufficient. And so these are just some of the things that we can mention. But the thing is that as much as one is able to, if you can do all the different sunnahs of the Eid Salat, you know, that would be ideal. So, you know, even still, even if you're not going to be going outside of your home, you know, still, you know, making the ghusl for Salat al-Eid, which the ghusl for Salat al-Eid takes place anytime after Maghrib, the night before. So anytime after Maghrib the night before, you can make the ghusl with the intention for the Salat al-Eid. And then, you know, also the wearing of either new clothing or one's best clothing, for the men to put on some type of atar, some type of perfume, something that, you know, smells nice, and so on and so forth. And then also, you know, doing the dhikr of the day of Eid. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Wallahi alhamd. And, you know, as if you want to do more, you know, Allahu Akbar kabira, walhamdulillah kathira, you know, that can be done as well. You know, so as much as you can, you know, to fulfill the, you know, the normal sunnahs that we would be doing if we were not under this particular circumstance, you know, that, you know, is ideal, even if we're only going to be able to do it within our homes. And then also, you know, the sunnahs of, you know, reaching out to family and trying to, even if that's just with a phone call and so on and so forth. So inshallah, hopefully this will be some means of benefit. And inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept all of our worship during this month. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this a blessing for all of us in deen wa dunya akhirah. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Adam subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa kid. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.